To perform a good analysis is necessary to start with the power button. Pressing the power button is the first step to start an analysis. It is important to have an adequate laboratory power supply. Once you have the laboratory power supply, additional tests can be performed on the components to determine their status. If any failure is found, it can proceed to repair. The VBAT line is directly connected to the battery, and at the same time we have the power button, seen in the DZKG G700F schematic. The power button is accompanied by a pull-up resistor. This resistance helps us to start the device after the power button or power flex button has been pressed. This resistance is a key component to allow the phone to turn on and work properly. Right at the output of the device, there is a line called PWR on, which is activated when the power button is touched. This line connects the voltage to ground, which causes the phone to turn on. The main line is the VB8 line, which is the same as VPHPWR. This line in Motorola devices can also be called V+. When performing the button test, the power on cycle must start with the low current. If the current is not low, it means that something is not working properly and must be investigated immediately to determine the cause. The power on test, also known as the button press, is a diagnostic technique to determine the operation status of an electronic device, such as a mobile device in our case. This test involves the use of the laboratory power supply to measure the current following through the device when the power button is pressed for a very short time. This test is performed with the help of the laboratory power supply and should measure between 5, 10, 20 or 50 milliamperes. Usually, it is necessary to perform at least 3 tests to verify the behavior of the current in the laboratory power supply. This is done by pressing the power button for a very short time and observing the reading of the laboratory power supply. Depending on the model of our device, the consumption can be between 0.005 and 0.070 milliamperes. We are talking about a half second click. The Power Z can help us a lot to see these types of consumption. We have good tools in our laboratory to measure these currents, but to start with, a power supply normally is enough. We have all started with basic tools and then, over time, after generating money, we have invested in good tools. When the device is initializing correctly, the voltage always remains stable. However, if we press the power button for half a second and the result is a value of 200 or 300 milliamperes, it can be concluded that there is a failure in the device. If consumption increases to 300, 400 or 500 milliamperes, this can indicate a short in the battery line. To determine the exact cause, it's important to perform a diagnostic test to verify the battery line. The ignition point of the device is the battery line. We will perform some tests on different devices. We just have to press and release. On some occasions, the devices can show consumption of 0.8 of 0.9 amperes after pressing the power button. This is due to a short on the motherboard. After pressing the power button, the current value obtained are 0.030, 0.042, 0.042 and 0.042 amperes. If we leave the power button pressed, the current value will increase. These tricks help us to understand if the device works correctly. Later, we can verify the current value and check when the screen shows image. Mastering the power cycle in less than 5 minutes helps us to determine the guilty of the motherboard. If there is any problem with the CPU, memory, PMIC or some main line, we can easily identify it just by looking at the device consumption. Here we can clearly see the button press and when we have pressed the power button for over a second. We take another device. At first, we will work with some mid-low range devices so that everyone understands the process in a simple way. It doesn't matter if we are going to work with low, mid or high range. The diagnosis is the same. We just need to use a laboratory power supply and cables to directly connect the battery connector. In the latest models of Samsung, Xiaomi and Huawei, I recycle the battery flexes and, in this way, I can easily inject voltage. In this model, more of the same. When we pressing the power button, we have a small current and after pressing the button for more than a second, the current increases. Here we have found our first breakdown. We can see how the current stays linear and doesn't not rise. It stays at 0.075 amperes. Next, we'll see the button press on an analog source and then on a digital one. We start with the analog source and then we continue with the digital one.